Right, there must be something in the 2000-year diary. Oh, that is so not good.
That's really very bad. It's not even semi-bad, it's really bad. If human history has been altered, then that can only mean one thing. We're in deep, deep trouble. No. That was a smooth landing. I don't often say that. So, what I need to do is hopefully the TARDIS can withstand this amount of time reversal. Let's just hope the old girl's got it in her. Don't want to short circuit her, do I? No, I do not. Come on, old girl. Show me what you have got. Right. Whoa! Okay. No, that's not good. Oh, that is so not good. No, stop exploding. No, stop. Stop. Not good. This is not good. And stop. Come on, stop. I'm gonna have to leave the console room. It's gonna blow. Well, there's another console room totaled for a bit. What have I done? What have I done? But never mind, the emergency procedure should kick in any moment now. Or are they down to? Wait, no, maybe if the console lets me, I could override the safety features and hopefully the fire should dissipate. Ha, yes. See? I always knew that you would do this. You can always be relied upon, can't you? Sorry for giving you a bit of a battery in there, and I know it was me that started it, but oh well, at least I'm going to finish it now. Some of your power cells have depleted. That hardly ever happens. It must have been bad. So, if I can just draw enough power to. No, that. No, yes. Yes! If I can just draw enough power to materialize the next habitable planet in the area, that means that then I may be able to charge you up. Maybe able to. Can't promise, but you'll get there in the end. I just need somewhere to lie low. Why you do what you do.
Okay, so a new undiscovered alien planet. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Now, what I need should be on this planet somewhere. Just have to locate where. Right then, I think I will go and mingle with the locals or whatever passes for locals on this planet. That's if there is any locals. Actually, this way. I think I can sense something from this way.
Do-do-do-do-do. Oh, what to do? So bored. Just a bunch of old barrels, really. Oh well. Anyway. Whoa! Who are you? Who are you?
Hello, I'm the Doctor, and I'm so glad you asked because I never get tired of saying that. So, I need something from your planet, but I can't help but noticing something weird going on here. It seems like a bomb's dropped, like there's no one about, and this planet is normally, from what I can tell, quite busy, like a market. So, what's going on?
Finally, someone acknowledges it. You see, this place is ruled by the Great and Powerful One. You don't go against him.
The Great and Powerful One? Tell me more.
He lives in that temple that you passed by the village. Within that temple, he holds a source of power. A power source greater than any power source I've ever seen. Not that I've seen many. I'm rambling here. Sorry.
A power source? What kind? I mean, there's loads of different ones. There's keys to time, or there's locksmith keys, or the darksmith.
Oh, please stop going on. Look, the temple is... It's forbidden. It's forbidden to go in there. Look, I really would show you, but I can't.
Oh, I hate that word, forbidden. I absolutely hate that word. It just makes me want to know even more than I already do. So, you have backed yourself into a corner, because now I am going to ask even more for you to tell me what kind of power source, because this could be so important.
Fine. I'll take you. But if we are to go, then you have to be very, very quiet. If the temple is disturbed, who knows what might happen? You need to be very quiet. Promise me.
Oh, trust me. I can be quiet.
Then let's go. Follow me.
Well, this is strange, but I suppose nothing ventured, nothing gained.
Right there. Do you see it? The temple. That's where the Great and Powerful One keeps the power source.
Oh, the temple. You mean that big temple over there? The big temple. Yeah, I get it's a temple. But what's in it?
Really? Do I have to keep repeating myself to you? Please don't get me into trouble. Look, you're being very loud and being quiet. It's a rule in this place.
Who says? Is that a rule?
Why? Don't you do so well with rules? Actually, you know what? I can understand that from what I've experienced of you so far. Please, let's just get on with this.
Good. Woo! This looks sleek.
You're being loud. Stop.
There's no one here. Who are we going to upset?
Me! You're upsetting me right now! Stop!
Oh. Well, I suppose that's what Clara was for then. Still haven't got to grips with that. Whoa. I mean, no, that is... It's just... magnificent, beautiful! Where did you get the... Oh. Well, that's weird. Why do people keep just disappearing on me? First, Carlafix has his weird disappearing at, which is still kind of cool, even though he's a bad guy. And now this guy disappears. You know how highly rude that is? Ooh. One word I can't stand, but also one that intrigues me. Dungeon. Do I not? Choices, choices, choices. Well, You only live once, but in my case, you live 13 times over. So why not? Let's go! Whoa, what a ride. That was actually fun. I enjoyed that. Ooh. But I've got my screwdriver wet. Brand new Sonic screwdriver and already wet. Brilliant. Now, the dungeon. I wonder if something was so powerful and so dangerous, what would they keep in? And my guess would either be a cellar or a dungeon. And looky what I found myself in! A dungeon! Looks like things do work out for me. Sometimes. Well, most of the time. Well, kind of. I really need someone to talk to, otherwise I'm talking to myself and it gets very confusing. Oh.
Okay. Not that way, I think. A different way.
Oh.
There's some that side too.
Forwards? Forwards.
Oh. Oops. Looks like I'm gonna need a plan.
Hey, zombies! Go fetch!
Doctor, be careful. Please, be careful.
Oh my god. So that's where you ended up.
Look, Doctor, it's very nice of you to come and save me and everything, but you need to go now. Your great and powerful one will not be happy. I assure you of that.
No, you'll be fine. If I can talk to him, I can sort this mess out.
Well, you can talk to him right now.
Where?
Behind you.
Well, hello there, Doctor. Nice to meet you.
How do you know who I am, Megatron?
Mock me all you like, Time Lord. For I have your means of transportation.
You have the TARDIS, do you? Good luck getting into it. I've got the key. And I've also got the control mechanism for it. And I've also got everything that you need to. Because, guess what? Isomorphic. So good luck trying to get into her, because she'll never let you in.
But you didn't estimate me using the power source. You see, that crystal there is the most powerful thing I've ever obtained. And I've obtained a few things in my time. Those doors will fly open.
You're deluded. That power source isn't going to break into a Type 40 TARDIS. You'd need more power in it. And I don't see on this planet how you're going to get that much power.
You know what? You're in shock. Let me show you myself. This will blow your tiny Time Lord mind. Come with me. You see this, Doctor? You thought you left it upstairs. Quick to transport. Quick to break into a Type 40 TARDIS. With it here, are you really going to take the chance?
That's impossible.
Oh yes, maneuvering the TARDIS itself wasn't difficult either. I used the power source to do that. The abilities of this crystal is quite infinite. So, what do you have to say for yourself, Doctor? Are you willing to take the chance?
You literally cannot do that. I mean, if you do, it could tear a hole in the fabric of space and time, create a black hole that will suck in every single universe, every single planet in this universe. Do you really want to go with that?
Oh, isn't it sweet that the Time Lord praises his machine so much?
You are sadistic.
Sadistic, no. See, I want to make the world better. I will transport myself back through time to make everyone like myself. A better race.
You're deluded. I don't see how you can even believe that. You don't even know what you're talking about. You are just here by chance because of something that happened in a genetic experiment lab. You don't even know what you're doing. You're just programmed to do one thing, and that is to seek and destroy. And it's not going to happen on my watch.
You seek to belittle me. You seek to make me feel weak. You will regret this.
I need to stop this. But then again, last time I messed with something like this, I completely wrecked the moon landing, which I still kind of need to put back, but I need to sort this first, because without the power source to the TARDIS, because it's got no power. Well, it has got power, but it hasn't got enough to do what I need to do. What's good's a time machine if it won't travel through time? It can hardly manage traveling through space. I have under a minute left, maybe 30 seconds maximum. What do I do? What do I do? Unless I'm sorry, but I've got to protect time and my TARDIS. I'll be back for you. Just give me 5 minutes just to get this sorted, and I'll be back. I hope. Right, so all I need to do is try and sneak around this power source, and then what I can do is craftily, with a few little bits of technical engineering and brilliance, I can dematerialize the TARDIS and rematerialize it around the power source itself, thus diffusing it from doing whatever it was going to do to the TARDIS in the first place. So, let's hope this works. Now, this is going to be the complicated bit. Not only do I have to land the TARDIS an hour before I originally landed, before I arrived, I have to set the alarm clock. Haven't done that for ages, not since, when was that? 1999. Haven't done that for ages. And create a temporal orbit around time vortex to make sure that the other TARDIS and my past self does not pick up the signal of this TARDIS, otherwise that could cause even worse repercussions. And now, to be a tiny bit clever, all I've got to do is flip, and a little bit of razzle dazzle, a little bit of that lever, a little bit of this lever, and we should be landing any minute now. Oh god, I never realized how much I love that noise. The noise of my TARDIS. It's the sound that something brilliant is about. What'd you say, old girl? Time for another adventure? Because there is one waiting for me in a cell right now. Do I drag someone else in here and risk their life? Or do I actually make someone's life better? I guess there's only one way to find out.
Wait. You didn't leave me. You came back for me. Oh, Doctor, thank you. Thank you so much. How can I ever repay you? Okay. Rambling again. Sorry. Thank you.
Wow.
Okay, next thing is, how are we going to get out of here?
Well, I could
drop you at the nearest planet, or we could, I don't know, have a few adventures. But before you answer yes or no, one question. How far will you go for adventure?
Quite far, but I don't know.
Right then. That's us settled. So, first things first, you might want to brace yourself. If you've never been off this planet, this might come as a bit of a shock to you, but I'll let it explain itself. Come on, in here.
Bring it on.
I will have that machine soon.